le van a... Okay? So again, the two purposes of listing with the Philippine Stock Exchange is to raise working capital, and the other one is to have a convenient facility for the purpose of trading, and for example, in trading, that's buying and selling of shares of a corporation. Yung term na trading, it may be understood in its ordinary sense. Pag sinabing trading, namimili, ibinebenta. Buying and selling. Okay? Oh, maliwanag. Alright. Now, I don't know if you had heard it before, but when a person buys shares which are listed at the stock exchange, his investment in such shares is considered very liquid. Okay? Why? Because if shares are listed with the Philippine Stock Exchange and you would like to sell them, you can sell them right away. The only exception is when the corporation whose shares you own is already bankrupt, in which case, nobody would buy those shares. Kaya lang kung listed yan, halimbawa, right? Halimbawa, meron kang San Miguel shares, o meron kang shares ng Ayala Corporation, o meron kang shares ng Metro Bank, o meron kang shares ng Banco de Oro. Kung gusto mo ibenta yan sa Tuesday, halimbawa, kailangan mo ng pera for enrollment purposes. Sabi ng eskwela, last day na ho sa Tuesday ang enrollment. Walang problema. You call up your broker, and the broker, in a matter of seconds, probably minutes, he can sell your shares. Kaya nga sinasabing liquid kasi easily convertible into cash. Okay? Investments in shares which are listed with the Philippine Stock Exchange is considered liquid. Why? Because these shares could readily be sold through the exchange. Get it? Gusto mo magbenta? Mabilis. Gusto mo rin bumili? Mabilis. Just a telephone call. And you can sell or you could buy. Okay? Mas mahirap pa nga kumisa magbenta ng house and lot. Yung house and lot mo, dalawang taon na, hindi pa na ibibenta. Kaya alam, meron kang shares of stock, seconds lang yan. Matagal na yung minutes, you can sell. But that is, you do it through the exchange. Okay? Alright, now, I'll illustrate this later on. Alright, ngayon, going back to the rule, I'm going very basic in my presentation. Kaya, pasensya na kung paulit-ulit ako. Reason is I want you to have a very good idea of what securities are. Okay? Alright. So, you were able to register your securities with the SEC. Alright? Question is, if your securities would consist of shares of a corporation, if those shares had already been registered with the SEC, shall that registration with the SEC assure you of listing with the Philippine Stock Exchange? Here is a corporation. It applied for registration of its shares with the SEC. Pasado. Alright. Kaya lang, before the shares could be made available to the public, kinakailang i-list muna yan sa Philippine Stock Exchange. Question now is, as those shares were already registered with the SEC, shall that assure listing of the shares with the Philippine Stock Exchange? Answer, no. Although the shares were already registered with the SEC, such registration is not an assurance that those shares would be listed with the Philippine Stock Exchange. And we have an actual case on this. The case of Puerto Azul Land Incorporated, briefly known as PALI, Puerto Azul Land Incorporated. All right. You must have heard of Puerto Azul. Okay? Puerto Azul is a beach resort in Cavite. Right? And in the 70s, before they discovered other tourist destinations in the country, particularly Boracay, Puerto Azul was the prime tourist destination in the 70s. Okay? I had seen this with my own eyes. During those days, I passed by Puerto Azul, and I saw long queues of tourist buses going to Puerto Azul. And most of the tourists at that time were Japanese. Okay? All right. So the Japanese enjoyed Puerto Azul very much. Okay? Kasi yun naman Puerto Azul, although hindi yan white sand, black sand yan. Kaya lang, the development was very nice. It was according to world standards. World-class standards. Kaya lang, that was in the 70s. World-class pa yan noon. Alright, now towards the end of the 90s, I think sometime 1997 or 1998, Puerto Azul needed to upgrade its facilities to world-class standards. Yung facilities maayos pa rin naman during those days. Kaya lang, not anymore world-class. Okay? The facilities were still okay, but ano na, obsolete na yung materials. Alright, to illustrate. If you had been to hotels which were just put up, pag pumunta ka sa mga lobbies niyan, ang tiles niyan, hindi ganyan, yung marble, luma na yan. Ha? Panlapida nga, hindi na pa tinatanggap yan. Okay? Nowadays, developers don't use marbles anymore. Kaya yan, yung marble tiles sa Twisi, okay pa naman, di ba? Yung flooring natin, okay pa naman. Kaya lang hindi na world class yan. Yan, wala class na yan. Okay, hindi na world class, wala class. Why? Because nowadays, pag nagpunta ka sa mga malls, yung mga bagong tayo, punta ka sa mga five-star hotels, what do you see that they use for their floorings? Di ba mga ceramic tiles? Yung madulas na pag hindi ka marunong lumakad, siguradong babagsak ka. Okay? Oh, that's one. Tiles pa lang yun. Oh, you go to restrooms of the five-star hotels nowadays. Meron ka bang makikita ang mga countertops where marble was used? Wala na. Yan ang old tech. Nowadays, what they use is granite. Di ba? Oh, okay. To cite some more changes in technology. I'll talk about what I know personally. Huh? Alright. If you go to old hotels which had not been renovated since they were established many decades ago. Pag pumunta ka sa restroom ng males, okay? The urinals, men in the restroom have urinals. Girls, I don't think you have. You do it sitting down, we do it standing up. Okay? So, we use urinals. Alright. What an old technology. To flush, lever type. Pull down. Okay? But you go to newly established buildings, especially mga five-star hotels, you don't touch anything. Why? Kasi, kinakailangan mag-improve ang technology. Alright. Here. Yun dati, after a man has used the urinal, he flushes it using the lever. And that's not sanitary. Why? When a man urinates, he has to hold this thing. Otherwise, the urine could be going everywhere. Depende sa pressure yun. Para rin host yan. Pag malakas ang pressure ng host, di ba gumagano? Pag loaded yun, pag malakas ang pressure, pag hindi mo hinawakan yun, kung saan-saan pupunta yung urine. Alright. Kaya lang, after holding it, tapos masama pa ang pwesto nung ano, yung lever to flush. Dapat yun, dapat nasa left. Kasi yung right, that's the right hand of the man, is used to hold this thing. Kaya pag hinawakan mo yun, there could be millions of germs in it. Okay? Ilihahawakan mo yung lever, so some germs are transmitted to the lever. Okay? So, kawawa naman yung susunod na user. Okay? He will touch it. So, in short, very unsanitary. Alright? So, people thought of improving or innovating. Sabi nila, alam nila yung problema. So, they came out with a better technology, push button. Kaya dati ito, buong kamay, ngayon, button na lang. Thumb na lang. But then, still not safe. So, now, you don't touch anything. Alright? If you want to use the urinal, just open your zipper. Okay? Then do your thing. Alright? And after doing your thing, you close your zipper. Alright? And water flows down. Okay? And how do they do it? They use sensors. Spelled as SENSORS. Okay? Alright. When the sensor no longer sees the bird, it flushes. Habang naandun yun, hindi yun nagpa-flush. Kaya lang pag naisara mo na yung zipper, yeah. Kaya lang, ingat raw kayo. I don't know how accurate may camera raw yun. Alright, may hidden camera. Alright. O, ngayon, after a man has done his thing, anong ginagawa? Anong tamang gawin? Dapat wash hands. Diba? Alright, old technology. Diba yung faucet, may head, iikot yun. That's not sanitary. Why? You just touch your thing and then you're going to hold the head of the tap with your hand. Alright? So in short, improved technology, push button. Alam problema, push button dito naman sa pump. Recent technology, sensors na rin. All that you have to do is put your hand under the tap, move it a little, then water starts flowing. Okay? Now, after that, what do you do? Dati doon sa mga restrooms ng, bawa, like Manila Hotel, way back in the 70s, meron sila yung long rolled towel made of cloth. Malaki roll yun nun. Parang bang yung paper towel na naka-roll na yung ginagamit sa kusina. Right? Kaya lang, this one is made of cloth. You pull it down, wipe your hand, dapat pull down. Again, para yung next user, gagamitin niya malinis na. But then, not many people know how to use it. Okay? Kaya pagkapunas ganun, bahala ka na. Okay? Alright, so in short, as a better solution, they started using paper towels. Okay? Yung folded na yan, hila ka lang. Ang problema, very expensive. Especially with Filipinos around. Why? Kukuha ng isa. Tutuyuin. Throw. May konting basa pa, kuha pa ng isa. Yan, tuyo na, tapon. Kaya lang, kuha pa ng marami yun. Iuwi yun. Di ba? Oh, very expensive. So, they came out with something better, yung hand dryer. All that you do is push button. Kaya lang, hindi pa rin maayos yun. Kasi meron pa rin contact. So nowadays, present technology, sensor pa rin. Just move your hand, and hot water, hot air starts coming out. Okay? So yun ang technology sa restroom ng lalaki. Now, in the case of women, I know women are using the toilet bowls whenever they are urinating. Ngayon,